Hey guys, welcome back to my long-awaited vlog. Sorry for the wait. I was originally planning on making this a one semester vlog, but I needed a break from social media, as one does. So lucky for you, you guys get a year-long semester vlog. Well, I guess it would just be like junior year. I feel like this format actually worked out for the best because you can see my progression in a short amount of time in one video, and I find that very fascinating and also good to document my personal growth as an artist. So here I'm doing a landscape just to work on my skills, and I was kind of experiencing a little bit of creative block, and I think it really was nurturing for my creative progression. One of my main goals for painting was to start working faster and developing a process that I was comfortable with so I can produce more work, more quality work. And this was also my first time taking a ceramics class. This was Intro to Ceramics, and boy, is it more physically taxing than I was expecting and super time consuming. But now I appreciate the craft, and I am extremely in love with making ceramics. And every time I go to a craft show, I just need to know what cone everything was made at and what type of clay. I'm very nosy, but I've learned so much. Oh my gosh, and I've also progressed so much as a figure skater. So here is me getting my doubles back. For a while, I was focusing a lot on moves in the field, which is good, but I feel like jumping is just very freeing once you just let yourself do it, and it's really good for your confidence as a human and slay. I was having so much fun. Wow, yeah, so this is one of my first pieces that is truly experimental, and I'm really stepping out of my comfort zone. In that last piece, I was focusing on combining a bunch of different mediums into one painting, and that was also my first project in ceramics class, so that was fun. It was really fun, and now I'm doing an extra credit project because I would literally sit there for like 8 hours straight and just make stuff, and it was kind of meditative, although my back really hurt after this class, but you do get really shredded, so I totally recommend it. And this was another assignment for my oil painting class that I was making a collage box, so I would make a bunch of different pieces intuitively through different mediums and combine them and make different compositions. And I think this was really, really good for the development of my process, because I feel like when I work more intuitively and I'm not overthinking, my work ends up turning out better. And also going to exhibitions and seeing people around you who are making art is extremely motivating and enriching. So go to as many galleries as you can. That's the one thing I've really learned. It's so fascinating and inspiring. And I was taking a professional practices class too, and we were also forcing ourselves to work out of our comfort zone. So I found a found object, which was an acorn head, and I made a little scarecrow guy with it. I'm not really comfortable sewing, but I think sewing will complement my work better in the future once I start this process of more experimentation. And I had so much fun. Sewing is not easy though. I respect anyone who's a sewer or seamstress. That's awesome. A lot of these in-between clips are me cooking a date with my mom and my sister on the weekends. Super fun, super easy. And you always get a sweet treat after because the ice rink is super cold and we deserve to feel happy and warm inside. Especially since it's so cold out. Look at me, I have to wear a sweater, a jacket in the studio. That sounds so sucky. But look at her, she's there, she's working, yes! So this is my second project, or my independent project. So this is really me, again, pushing myself to combine contemporary topics with my art making process. And I feel like this was also really good for my creative confidence because I got to work with oils again. I was not working with oils for a while, and it makes me sad because I love how juicy oils look on the canvas, because clearly, look at that. Oh, it just like has so many textures. I'm obsessed. And so, what was the name of that one? I totally forget, but it had to do with regenerative farming. So there's that. There's the idea, the combination. I think it was successful, so period. There's always a first for everything, so this was my first time going to a giga church. Oh my gosh, was it so cool. I was not expecting this church to be a whole production. Oh my gosh, if you keep watching, you'll see some of a winter show I went to see there, and it was absolutely insane. More moves, let's go. I should be testing my moves soon. Kind of got postponed because of ice show and all that good stuff, but luckily for me, my rink that I grew up in commissioned me to make a mural in the ice rink. Like, how awesome is that? I am so extremely grateful to have the space to just do it on people's walls. Like, that's my absolute dream, and look at, here I am living it. I am so beyond blessed. The process, I think this is in another video I made, so if you go back on my channel, you'll see it, but I did design it in my sketchbook, and then I reworked it in Procreate on the iPad, and then boom, there she is. I used a projector to project it too. And now we're nearing the end of my semester one, and I was kind of getting burnt out of using my own creative power. I don't know, I think when you're starting off trying to find your own creative voice, like, it just gets hard. You need to, like, nurture that and give it its space. So I decided to make Alla Prima paintings. That's why I started making Santa, just to, again, work on developing my skills, making sure I'm working fast, and, like, establishing the oil painting process into my little noggin so I can just do it without even thinking. Yeah, look at, there's Santa, he's slaying, and I got all this free paint. That's the awesome thing about going to art schools, because some people, they just are taking the class once and they leave it, so that's awesome. So here are some more Alla Prima paintings. So usually you sit down for like 3 hours and try to finish it within that time period. I did my best and I was pretty proud of that. And this is like my last project for my ceramics class. I think that was a trompe-l'oeil project, I'm pretty sure. So you basically take one word and make objects that are related to it, and the people have to guess what that word was that inspired your creations. And this is a abstraction project, I think, but we had to go to the DIA and find a painting and a ancient vessel to inspire our creation. So I found a cubist painting, and I found one that was made from ancient civilization. I don't even know. As you can see, Shannon is now jumping in her pants because it's winter break and I finally get a break. And so I got influenced by social media and decided to make a little citrus garland to hang up in my room. I originally did this completely wrong, and I was like, why aren't these drying out? Because you're supposed to pat them before you put in the oven. But I eventually figured it out, and so I love it. It's so cute. I was gonna put it on my tree, but I felt like my tree turned out a little bit gaudier than I expected. But with a touch of these little coquette bows, OMG. Turned out absolutely stunning, darling. Thanks to my grandma for buying me the bulbs. So cute. I was not kidding about that, you guys. There was flames in church. That was so epic. I ended up entering two pieces into a local exhibition, and I met someone really cool there who invited me to do a artist residency, but unfortunately the dates did not work out, so I cannot go this summer. But that was okay, I could still put on my resume, so a win is a win. And now we're entering my next semester, and I was not expecting myself to become a full-on chemist, because I had to design my own glazes, which was really awesome. I fell in love more with ceramics after that. And this is my wearables project. I made a monkey bra. It was really cute. Wait for the photos, they're coming up soon. This was my abstraction project that I made in that same class. It was an abstraction of a carousel, and it was supposed to represent the lolling motion. I named it Nostalgic Primordial Memories, just because it needed to be a little bit more wordy, because it got into the undergraduate exhibition, which I'm super thankful for. And here is my friends cheering me on, but unfortunately my monkey bra did not go over my head, so I had to figure out another way to wear it. But none of these ways that I'm showing you is not the ways I'm gonna wear it. I just thought they were funny. And this is also me plugging ceramics again, because it's totally a full body workout. Like, I became so shredded from taking this class. And so here is my dad helping me Well, he did help me by shaving down the inside, but unfortunately it still did not fit over my head. But I actually think it ended up adding a little bit more texture to the piece, and I incorporated more black elements so it matched my black pants for my little photo shoot at the end. And I look like a steampunk superhero, which was totally a vibe. I'm obsessed with that photo shoot. I had so much fun. So this is a collage project. At the beginning of my first semester, we had a really weird professor, but we resolved the issue. But these are some of the pieces I made for that, and I'm really proud of that first one because it was very intuitive, very quick, and I loved the incorporations of all the textures. And here again is me playing with all of my extra stuff from my collage project from last semester, and I combined it also on my sketchbook here and in that last piece. And I was experimenting with felting, which was really fun. I'm obsessed with that. I need to play with that a little bit more. I feel like that with ceramics would be really cool. And so I ended up working on one piece this semester. I guess really three, but one big one, because this was my semester proposal and it was going to take up a lot of time, and it was really stepping out of my comfort zone. I've never worked on a piece this big, and I'm obsessed with it. It's a like very surrealist abstraction and like another visual language. And I feel like I had a lot of learning lessons during this one and lots of good conversations with my professor. And I'm really excited for where this is going to take me. I'm eventually going to combine this in conversation with a handmade sketchbook with different sketches like this, because I tend to start from my sketchbook and I don't see why that can't just not be the end result of itself. So this totally opened up a lot of new doors for me, new processes. So I had so much fun. And the semester finally came to an end, and I was very proud of myself for not getting burnt out this time. I honestly felt pretty proud of myself. And I was also pushing myself to be a little bit better at skating, and I've been training a little bit harder and having a lot more fun with it. So lots of progression from the beginning of this video even. So yeah, that's really cool. This is also my mother's ice show, her production. She is also very creative and cool, just like me. No, I'm just kidding. But I thought this was amazing. Like, those props turned out amazing. Kudos to all the parents who helped make this production. And this is my friend Pauline Muscat. Go follow her. She also is a ceramicist. She's always active on social media, and she has workout videos. She's so freaking cool. I love her so much. So yeah, definitely go check her social media out. And this is my solo. I had a coaching solo, and it was definitely more challenging than any of the other programs I was doing, but that was super good for my endurance and also my confidence, and it also made me more motivated to want to continue skating for fun. That's why I do it, for fun, and performing my heart out and taking up more space, because that's so important as a 20-year-old teenage girl. There's the only double I landed. I never landed it in show. I landed it the only practice where nobody was watching except for like two people. So, you know, just skater things you can never do in front of people. But that's okay. I was definitely being too timid, but I feel like my spiral is definitely carrying this whole program, so I really had nothing to worry about. It was really fun. I had so much fun doing this. And skating with my friends and some of my old friends from years ago I used to do ice show with. Now I'm coaching with them and doing some numbers, and it's just so fun. It's just people I grew up with. And this dress also is freaking gorgeous. It definitely needs more sparkles because I'm going to do more competitions this summer, and I'm planning on doing a summer vlog, and I hope you guys stay tuned for that, because I will be going and traveling and doing different collegiate competitions with this dress, hopefully with more jumps. So that'll be fun. And also I'm making more projects this summer. Like, I'm making paper right now, so stay tuned for that. I'm just really trying to push myself to experiment with different mediums in combination with some of my favorite mediums, like watercolor, oil, and ceramics. So there's so much good things to come. I'm also gonna do an art show, so that'll be fun for the vlog too. Hopefully it'll be shorter, because I want you guys to I want to stay in contact with you guys better, whoever's watching this. If you are watching this, then thank you so much. I'm totally not expecting anybody to, but I hope you've learned something from this, or what it's like in art school, or it just, you're just listening to it in the background if you're studying or something. That's always awesome. So thank you for watching. Have a beautiful day.